Hello children, myself Anindita Banerjee back again with another informative video for you all. I hope you are at your best health, stay at home. Please don't waste your time. Please be serious and study and work hard. Okay, I had already started with the second chapter. In my last video, I had already discussed about the breathing methods of different animals. Now today I will start with a new topic, that is movement or locomotion. Okay, so before I start with a new topic, let me revise what I had done before. Okay, I hope you are watching my videos regularly. Please do watch it and prepare your lessons well. Okay, now today I'll start with habitat once again. I'll just revise it with you once. Okay, now as you see it on the screen, what is habitat? The natural home or environment of a plant, animal or other organism is known as its habitat. Okay, now this habitat provides the animal with three things, that is food, water and shelter. Okay, and different animals live in different habitats. See, okay, different animals live in different habitats. Clear? So we have two main types of habitat. One is aquatic or water habitat, which includes salty water and fresh water. Okay, see, this is a picture of salty water which you find in the mobile screen or laptop, whatever you are watching at. Okay, now the second type of habitat is terrestrial or land habitat. Okay, and it includes forest. This is a picture of a forest and you can see a lion roaming in the forest. So this is the terrestrial or land habitat, which includes forest. This is a forest. Okay, forest habitat. Now this is a grassland. This is a grassland. Okay, this is a desert habitat. Desert habitat. Okay, now you have a polar habitat. Okay, and the last but not the least, this is mountain habitat. Clear? So two types of main habitats are there, that is aquatic or water habitats and terrestrial or land habitat, which includes what? Forest, then grasslands, then deserts, then polar regions, and then lastly mountains. Okay, now I'll discuss about terrestrial animals, which I already discussed in my earlier video. Still, I'll revise it once again with you. Now, animals that live on land are known as terrestrial animals. For example, see, you can see a picture of a lion. So, it is a terrestrial animal. Now, I come to aquatic animals. Animals that live in water are known as aquatic animals. You can see fish. Oh, okay. So, this is an example of aquatic animal. Now, we come to arboreal animals. What is arboreal animals? Some animals that mostly live on trees, they are known as arboreal animals. Example of arboreal animal is monkey. A squirrel is also an arboreal animal. Okay, now I come to amphibian. Okay, now what are amphibians? Animals that live partly on land and partly in water, they are known as amphibians. So this is a picture of a frog, snake. These are amphibians. Clear? Now I come to aerial animals. Now what do you mean by aerial animals? Some animals that can fly are known as aerial animals. Clear? Yes? Okay. Now I come to the next part, next topic in your book, that is on page 20, that is body coverings. Different animals have different body coverings for its protection. Okay? See, classification based on body coverings. Animal with scales. Snake and tortoise, their body is the body of snake and tortoise are covered with scale. Okay, animal with hair, monkey and bear. Animal with feather, all birds. Okay, so different animals have different body coverings. For instance, snail have shell, fishes have scales, crocodile have scales, lion have hair, Arctic fox have fur. Okay, this fur protects the Arctic fox from the harsh cold weather conditions. Okay, and sparrows, they have feathers, tortoise have shell, oyster have shell, sheep has wool, polar bear has fur, peacock has feathers, and snake also has scales. These are the different body coverings of different animals. So these body coverings protect the animals against their predators or against the weather. Clear? Now I come to, this is another body covering of a polar bear. Okay. Have you seen? Yes. Now I'll move to the next topic, that is camouflage. Yes, I've already discussed in my earlier videos. I think you have remembered what I had said. Yes, camouflaging means hide or disguise of a person, animal or object. Okay, so see, this is a picture of a butterfly. Okay, can you identify it? No, it is difficult to identify because it mingles with the surrounding. It mixes with the surrounding. So the predator or the enemy is not able to identify it. Okay, see the lizard, can you see? It has mingled with the branch it is sitting on, and it is very difficult to distinguish between it. Clear? Now we come to different ways of breathing. Different ways of breathing. Different animals breathe in different ways. Okay, different animals breathe in different ways. The chicken, they breathe with the help of lungs. Fishes, they breathe through gills. Caterpillars through spiracles. Okay, clear? And the spider through book lung, and sponge, you have seen outflow and inflow of air. Okay, these are the different methods of breathing. Yes, now I come to our topic today, that is movement or locomotion. Now, why do animals move from one place to another? They don't sit in one place, they have to move from one place to another. Why? They need to move from one place to another. First point, in search of food and water. Clear? Second point is to protect themselves from enemies. Okay? Now, suppose a deer is chased by a tiger or a lion. Will the deer sit and wait for the tiger to come and eat it? No, the deer will run. So animals need to move from one place to another to protect themselves from their enemies. And the third point is to look for shelter. So animals again move from one place to another in search of food and water. Second point, to protect themselves from enemies. And the third point is to look for shelter. Clear? Okay, now the terrestrial animals, that animals that live on land, have four limbs. That is F-O-U-R, four limbs. Okay, the front limbs are called four limbs. The front limbs are called the four limbs. Front, four. So don't mix up. Front limbs are called the four limbs, and the back limbs are called hind limbs. The back limbs are called the hind limbs. I'm giving you an example. Suppose those who are watching my videos, please raise your hands. Raise your hands, everyone. Yes, hands are the arms, or this is the four limbs of human beings. Clear? Now those who are sitting, please stand up. The legs are your hind limbs. Clear? Yes. Now this human beings, we use our hind limbs or legs to walk, to stand, to run and to swim. Okay, and the legs also help us to stand straight. Okay, and have erect position. Okay, have you understood? And the forelimbs or arms are used. We use our forelimbs or arms to hold objects. Clear? So we use our arms or forelimbs to hold objects. Clear? Now see, this is the picture on the screen. See, red lines represent the forelimbs. The red lines are the forelimbs or the arms. While blue lines represent the lower limbs or the legs. Can you understand? So have you understood the difference between the forelimbs and the hind limbs? Yes, I clear it once again. See, this is the left forelimb. Yes, forelimb. Have you seen? And this is the left hind limbs. Okay, the picture, can you understand? Okay, now I'll come, what is the difference between the forelimbs and the hind limbs? Okay, the front limbs are called the forelimbs. Front and fore. So don't mix up with hind limbs. The front limbs are called forelimbs, and the back limbs are called the hind limbs. So front limbs are called the forelimbs, and the back limbs are called hind limbs. Is it clear? Now the hind limbs of any animals are much, much stronger than the forelimbs. So the hind limbs of any animals are much, much stronger than the forelimbs. Clear? And the third point is, the bones of hind limbs are sturdier and longer than the bones present in the forelimbs. Now, what do you mean by sturdier? S-T-U-R-D-I-E-R. Okay? Sturdier means strong and healthy. That will not break easily. Have you understood? So, bones of hind limbs are much stronger and healthier and longer than the bones present in the forelimbs. Clear? So, have you understood the difference between forelimbs and hind limbs? Okay? So, the movement of human beings is clear to you? Yes. Now, we'll discuss the movement of horses. Can you see? This is the feet of who? Horses. Okay? So, horses, they walk and run on all the four limbs. F-O-U-R, not four limbs. It is F-O-U-R, four limbs or legs. Clear? Goats also, they walk and run on all the F-O-U-R, four limbs. Clear? Can you see the four limbs? Yes? Yes, one, two, three, four. Okay. Now, this is a picture of a tiger. Again, how they move? They also move with the help of, they walk or run, move with the help of F-O-U-R, four limbs. One, two, three, four. Can you see? Yes, clear? Yes. Now, giraffes, how they move? They also move with the help of their four, F-O-U-R, four limbs or legs. See? Can you see clearly? Yes. So, have you understood how the movement is done by horses, dogs, goats, tigers, giraffes? Yes? Yes. Now, I'll move to the kangaroos. Now, how do kangaroos move? Okay. Kangaroos hop on their hind limbs. Hind limbs, see? Can you see the picture of hind limbs? This is the picture of hind limbs. Okay. And these hind limbs are longer and stronger than their forelimbs. Have you understood? So, these are the hind limbs are much longer and stronger than the forelimbs. Clear? With the picture, with the help of picture, are you able to understand? Yes. So, have you understood the movement of kangaroos, how they hop? They hop, again I repeat myself, kangaroos hop on their hind limbs because they are much longer, okay, and stronger than their forelimbs. Clear? Yes. Yes. Now, we'll come to reptiles. Now, how do reptiles move? Okay. Now, this is a picture of a reptile. Again, let me tell you what are reptiles. Everyone remembers it, I think so. Yes. Reptiles are cold-blooded animals. Okay. And their bodies are covered with scales. Can you see the picture? It is covered with scales. Yes. And they do not give birth to babies directly, okay? They lay eggs, and when the eggs hatches, the baby reptile comes out. Clear? For example, we have crocodile, snake. These are all reptiles. Now, today I am going to discuss how these reptiles move, okay? Now, these crocodiles, they have four short legs. Can you see? The four short legs. The four short legs. So, they move with the help of this four short legs. One, two, three, four. Have you understood? So, these crocodiles have four short legs and they use these to crawl on the ground. See, it is crawling on the ground. Yes. Have you seen? Have you ever been to a zoo? You have seen crocodile crawling on the ground with the help of four short legs. Yes. Now, I'll move to another reptile, that is lizards. This lizards also, like crocodiles, have four short legs. Though more two are not visible. Okay. but they also have, like crocodiles, four short legs, and they use these four short legs to crawl on the ground. Clear? So how do reptiles like crocodile and lizard move? Have you understood? Yes. Now we'll move to another reptile, that is a lizard. Yes. Now look at the top of your ceiling. Can you find any lizard? It may be or it may not be also. But we often find lizards, okay, crawl on the wall or ceilings of our houses. Yes, see, the lizard. Yes. Are you afraid of it? I'm very much afraid of lizards, you know. See, it is crawling on the wall and the ceilings. They also crawl. Okay, they also have four short legs. See, four short legs. Yes. So how they move? They move with the four short legs. They crawl on the walls or the ceilings of our houses. Clear? Now I'll move to another reptile, that is snake. Have you seen the picture of a snake? Never go near it. Only see pictures, okay? So snakes, they do not have any legs. Have you seen? No legs are found. So how do these reptiles move? They have scales on underside of their bodies, okay? These snakes, they have scales on underside of their bodies. And their muscles are very strong, you know. They have very strong muscles. And they have a flexible backbone, see? Because they move in any direction. They have flexible, how they move? They have very flexible backbone, okay? So, the three things, the snakes is, first of all, they have scales on the underside of their bodies. Their muscles are very strong and their backbone is flexible. Clear? And all these features help the snake to grip the ground and move. Have you understood? So all these features help the snake to grip the ground and move. See, it is moving. Clear? Clear? Yes. Now we come to the next section. Or next topic of your book, that is insects. Now, how do insects move? Yes, can you see the picture of an insect? Insects have six legs. See, can you see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, insects have six legs that help them to move. Here. Now, we come to a picture of an ant. You have seen, every one of you have seen ant. This is also an example of an insect. So how this ant move? They crawl on their legs. So ant crawl on their legs. Six legs. They have six legs. Can you see? Count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So they use the six legs to move. They crawl on their legs. Okay. Now let's have some fun. Okay, Alice the insect. Alice the insect. Alice the insect has three parts. Alice the insect has three parts. Alice the insect has three parts. Head, thorax, abdomen. Boom, boom, boom. Alice the insect has six legs. Alice the insect has six legs. Alice the insect has six legs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? Okay. Now children, if you are tired hearing my video, please have a glass of Horlicks and again sit for watching. Okay. Now, have you understood? Yes. Now we'll move to the cockroach. Cockroach is another example of insect. Okay? Now, how do these cockroaches move? Cockroach also have six legs. Cockroaches also have six legs. They move with the help of these six legs. They crawl on the ground. Okay, they crawl on the ground. Clear? They crawl on the ground. See, again, cockroach is crawling on the ground with the help of six legs. Clear? Yes. Now I'll move to another insect. This is a grasshopper. Okay. They have grasshoppers. They have long hind limbs. Which are the hind limbs? See this hind limbs. Have you seen? These are the hind limbs. So grasshoppers have long hind limbs, and these hind limbs are used for hopping. These hind limbs are used for hopping. So grasshoppers have long hind limbs, and they use these hind limbs for hopping. Clear? Yes. Now we'll come to another picture of a grasshopper. Can you see? See the long hind limbs? Yes. So they use these hind limbs for hopping. Clear, children? Yes. So grasshoppers use this hind limbs for hopping. Okay. Now we'll come to another stick insect. This also uses its long hind limbs. Long hind limbs for hopping. Clear? So grasshoppers and stick insects, both of them have long hind limbs, and they use this for hopping. Clear? Yes? Yes. Now I'll move on to another picture of a grasshopper. Have you seen? Okay. They have long hind limbs. Clear? See? Another picture of a grasshopper. Yes. Now we move to butterflies. Now how do these insects move? Everyone have this answer. They have wings for flying. They have wings for flying. So how do butterflies move? They use their wings for flying. Yes. They use for flying. Yeah. See another picture of a butterfly. Such a beautiful butterfly. So how do this butterfly move? With the help of wings again. Okay. Again with the help of wings. Now this is a picture of a moth. Now how do these move? Again with the help of wings. They have wings for flying. Clear? This is another picture of a moth. Yes. Another picture of a moth. Okay. Now this moth also have wings for flying. Another picture of a moth, can you see? It moves with the help of wings. That means it fly with the help of their wings. Now children, a question may arise in your mind that what is the difference between butterflies and moth? Though it is not in your book, but I think I should clear the concept. Okay. Now see, it is on the screen. It's given on the screen. See. Butterflies are active during the day. Okay, they are very much active during the day, and moths are active during the night. Okay, when we are sleeping, the moths are active. Okay, see different. You understand? Now butterflies have clubbed antenna. That means the antennas are clubbed, joined together, and moths typically have feather-like antenna. Okay, yes. And butterflies are beautifully colored, but moths are not colored so beautifully. Clear? Now I'll show you the difference once again. See, moths, they are active at night or nocturnal. Okay, and butterfly, they are active during the day or diurnal. Moth, they are dull colors. They have dull colors, and butterfly, their colors are very bright. Okay, and for moth, their wings rest at their sides. Okay, and for butterflies, wings rest together and upright. See, can you see the picture? Now, feathered or pointed antenna. These moths, they have feathered or pointed antenna. And this for butterflies, they have straight and clubbed antenna, which I had told you before. And this moth, their body is thick, thick body. And for butterfly, it is thin. Their body are thin. So I think so. The concept of butterfly and moth are clear to you all. Yes. Now I come to the next part. Okay. This is a picture of a dragonfly. Okay. This is a picture of a dragonfly. When you were small, I think you used to catch this, but dragonflies with thread and tie their strings, wings with the strings. Yes? Okay. This is a picture of a dragonfly. Now, how does this dragonfly move? With the help of wings. They fly with the help of their wings. Clear? See another picture of a dragonfly. See, it is moving with the help of its wings. Can you see the picture? Yes. Now, these wings are made of thin scales that can be of different colors. See, thin scales. Okay. And it is made up of different colors. Okay. Okay. Now we come to, have you seen the picture of a bed bugs? Yes. This is a picture of a bed bug. Now, how do this insect move? They move by crawling. See, can you see? It is crawling. Yes. It moves by crawling. Okay. Now, again, one more picture of bed bug and the small bed bugs over there. So, it is moving with the by crawling. It is moving by crawling. Okay. Now, another picture of a bed bug. It is moving by crawling. Okay. Now, we come to lice. You know, you see where it is? On hair. So, please wash your hair. Okay. See, lice. You find it on the head. And how does this lice move? It also moves by crawling. Clear? Yes. Now, this is another picture of a lice. Okay. It also moves by crawling. See. Now, we will come to aerial animals. I have told you what are aerial animals. Animals that spend most of their time in air are known as aerial animals. Okay. They have two legs. They hatch from eggs. That means they lay eggs, and from when the eggs hatches, a baby bird comes out. They have very light bodies with feathers. They have hollow and light bones. Okay. And most fly with the help of their wings. These are the characteristics or features of aerial animals. Okay. Okay. See, these are the characteristics or features of aerial animals, which is on the screen. Let me read it once again. Animals that can fly and spend a lot of their time in the air are called aerial animals. Okay. So, the animals that can fly and they spend most of their time in the air, they are known as aerial animals. Their hollow bones make their bodies light. So, the hollow bones make their bodies light. They have one set of limbs modified as wings to help them to fly. And the body shape of aerial animals is such that they are able to cut through the air easily. Okay, they are able to move forward. And in cold winter months, when the food becomes scarce means very little, many birds fly towards warmer countries in search of food and warmth. And this mass movement of birds from colder to warmer place is called migration. Clear? I'll discuss about this later on. Okay. Now, example, almost all birds except flightless birds, they are all aerial animals. Clear? Now, I'll discuss every point with a picture. Yes. Now, have you seen the picture of a bird? Yes. And its body streamlined. The first point or the first characteristic feature of a bird is their body streamlined body. Yes. So, they are able to cut off their air and move forward. Yes. See, streamlined body. Just like there is water resistance, there is a force called air resistance. Air resistance that opposes, that means it stops the motion in air. So, when a bird is flying, its streamlined body shape helps to reduce air resistance. Okay? It helps to reduce, lower the air resistance and helps the bird to move forward. Clear? Yeah? Now see birds' characteristics. Four limbs are modified into wings. The four limbs, I told you what are the front limbs or the four limbs, are modified into wings for birds. Okay. And hind limbs are modified for swimming, walking or perching. They have feathers on their body, you know, and they are warm-blooded. Yeah. See the feathers, can you see? Four limbs are modified into wings. This is the pictures of four limbs which are modified into wings of birds. Yes. See four limbs. Can you see the picture of four limbs? Four limbs are modified into wings. And the hind limbs, what? They are the legs of the birds. Now I'll come to the next picture or next point, next characteristics of birds. That is, they have hollow bones. These are the hollow bones which make their body light, and they are able to move. They are able to fly. Clear? See, hollow bones, have you understood? What does hollow bones means? See, hollow bones of birds which make their body light and they are able to fly. Clear? See, they have hollow bones which make their body light, and this enables the bird to fly. Okay, now we come to the next characteristics of birds. That is, they have strong chest muscles that provide energy for flying. They have strong chest muscles, okay, which provide energy for flying. See, the chest muscles, they have strong chest muscles that provide energy for flying. The bird is able to fly. Yes. Now, see, birds, we come to the next characteristics. That is, they have tail, which helps them to change direction while flying. So birds, they have tail, which helps them to change the direction while flying. They have tail, okay, which helps them to change the direction while they fly. Clear? Now they have, the next characteristics feature of birds is they have claws. They have claws, okay, that help them to walk on the ground and sit. See, the bird is sitting now. Or perch on tree branches. Clear? Have you understood? See, the claws that help them to walk on the ground and sit or perch on tree branches. Yes, see? Yes, clear? The claws help them to walk on the ground and sit or perch on tree branches. Clear? Yes. Now we'll move to the next part of the lesson. That is, some birds, they have very large, you know, and heavy bodies and poorly developed wings. Therefore, they cannot fly. This is a picture of an ostrich. You know, ostrich is a flightless bird. That means they are not able to fly. Why they are not able to fly? Because they have large and heavy bodies and their wings are not developed nicely. That is why they are not able to fly. This is a picture of an ostrich. Ostriches rather. Clear? Again, another picture of an ostrich. Okay, see, you have seen the body is heavy and large, and they have poorly developed wings which does not support in flying. Again, another picture of a ostrich. Now we come to, this is a picture of a cassowaries. It is another flightless bird. Okay, see, you see by the picture you can understand its body is heavy and large, and they have poorly developed wings which does not support cassowaries for flying. This is another picture of a cassowary which does not allow it to fly because of its heavy body, poorly developed wings and large body. Another picture of a cassowary. Yes. Yeah. Now this is a picture of emu. Yes, it is also another example of flightless bird. Yes, emus also have large and heavy bodies and poorly developed wings. So these emu also cannot fly. Clear? See another picture of a emu. It is also another example of flightless bird. It cannot fly. Yes. Now another example of a penguin, which is also flightless bird. It has poorly developed wings, so it is not able to fly. Clear? And heavy body also. See, so many penguins, they have poorly developed wings. Okay, so they are not able to fly. It is another example of flightless birds. Clear? See, so many pictures of penguins. Now we come to bats. Okay, it is a flying mammal. Okay, it is a flying mammal, and the skin from their body is stretched to join the forelimb. Okay, forming a wing. Yes, see, yeah, see, this is another picture of a bat flying. It is also a mammal, and the skin from their body is stretched to join the forelimbs. Skin is joined. Okay, have you seen? Another picture of a bat which is flying. The skin from their body is stretched to join each forelimb, and it is forming the wing. Okay, so today I discussed about habitat, then the different types of habitat, then aquatic habitat, this is the forest habitat, then we have polar habitat, then desert habitat. Desert habitat, okay? Yes. Yes. So I end up till here. So next day I'll continue with this chapter. That is, I'll start with aquatic animals. Till then, please watch my videos and please go through the website, because I'd already uploaded the chapter over there. Please read it. If you have any problem, in comment you can write. I'm there for you to answer your queries. Okay, so please subscribe so that when only I upload any videos, you get its notification. Thank you for watching. Once again, thank you, children.